What's going on, Panther Nation? Bill Mack here with another edition of the Panther Prowl. Glad you folks could join me for another video as I give you my opinions, thoughts on the Panthers 2020 season. Coming into it, of course, you know, with all this virus and stuff, there's a lot of changes, a lot of things going on. We're going into week three, of course. Glad you folks could join me. This is, of course, the Panthers going to the Chargers to take on the Los Angeles Chargers. Just give you a little update here. Of course, my opinions from last week as well. The Panthers got to get some sort of stability here. You know, last week was a disappointing game for us. However, we're traveling to Los Angeles this coming week. The new stadium, SoFi Stadium, that is the Los Angeles Chargers' new stadium. They opened up, of course, last week against the Chiefs. I thought it was a good game. I'll give you a little in-depth here. It tells us that, of course, the Panthers will be the first NFC South opponent for the Chargers this year. It's supposed to be this coming Sunday on the 27th at 1 o'clock. The Panthers have only played the Chargers 7 times, of course, and the Panthers hold a 5-1 record, which the lone Charger win was the first time they met way back in 2004. So the Panthers kind of got a bit of a hot streak here on that. And the Chargers had a close game last week. They, however, lost in overtime to the Chiefs. You know, of course, we had a change in quarterback that came in. Taylor got hurt. Justin Herbert came in, had a really, really good game, as I will get into the stats here for you and give you a little bit of analysis on that. Taylor, however, was the quarterback that was initially started. You know, of course, last year a lot of changes with the Chargers. Phillip Rivers went to Indianapolis. This left the door. Tyrod Taylor, of course, was picked up in 2019. Justin Herbert started for them. He ended up in his NFL debut throwing 311 yards and a touchdown while rushing for another. Very impressive for the young rookie quarterback starting. We've got to get on this game. We've got to make sure we shut him down. And it wasn't just in the passing game. If we look back at the rushing game here through the first two games of the season, the Chargers are the top 6th ranked rushing defense, rushing team, averaging 169 yards. Of course, Austin Ekeler is second. He was second last year behind McCaffrey in yards and by running back. He's also in top 10 scrimmage as well. So we've got to really lock those two areas down. That's easier said than done because our defense is young. That's evident the last couple of weeks. You know, Russell Okung was talking, you know, in an interview after the game this past week, and he was just saying, you know, we've got to quit beating ourselves. I mean, we've got a good team. We just got to stop standing in our own way. And that's what they've got to do. You know, it's a whole new system there, whole new new head coach, new coaching staff. There's, you know, they're coming from the college ranks, which we know how college transition to the NFL does take time. We just can't be fans to quit to write off the Panthers already. These things take time. You know, we're having to rebuild. A lot of people don't like using the dreaded R word, but we're rebuilding. You know, we've got Teddy Bridgewater, and he did have a few mistakes last week. I will say that. But I'm not jumping off the train of Teddy Bridgewater just after a couple of games and a couple of losses. You know, this is a whole team thing. We got to have the offensive line. They protect. You know, they open up. One of the big blows from last week that I had gave you in my last review of that game was Christian McCaffrey going out with a little over 6 minutes left in the game after scoring his second rushing touchdown. Unfortunately, he's got a high ankle sprain, and he's going to at least miss no more than 3 weeks. The injury looked between, they said it could go between 4 to 6 weeks. But us knowing McCaffrey, he's going to want to try to get out there as soon as possible. But hopefully the coaching staff will be like, okay, take your time, slow down, and we'll see what you got to do. But, yeah, of course, you know, I'm looking forward to, you know, Mike Davis will get the start this week, and, you know, he's not the same kind of running back as McCaffrey is. Of course, not everybody is, but I think that the Panthers will definitely do well with him. We've just got to hold on tight. I mean, this is going to be a season. We've got to go into the Chargers. We've got to try to hopefully get some pressure. Those are areas, our defense, getting pressure to the quarterback, which is the same things I've stated, which we've got to do better and do more collectively of. Rushing the quarterback, trying to get pressures. Pressures create turnovers. Turnovers such as fumbles, such as interception. When you put a quarterback, especially a rookie quarterback, under duress, he can make timing mistakes and mistakes that could cause turnovers. Now, remember last week, the Panthers had two quick turnovers, which led them to 14 points in that game against you know, the Buccaneers and against Tom Brady in their home opener. So I'm looking forward to a little bit more maturity, a little bit more chemistry. This is a long season, Panther Nation. We don't need to give up. We don't need to wave the red flag, talk about tanking, all this other stuff I've seen on sites. We've just got to be behind our team. This will take some time. We can't be rushing. We can only back our team, hope the coaching staff learns from their mistakes, such as the clock management that we did see happen the past 2 weeks with Matt Rhule. Like I said, he's coming from the college ranks to the NFL. That clock management is so vital with the NFL team and with what's going on in the game and the flow of the game as well. So hopefully the Panthers can go to SoFi Stadium in Los Angeles and against the Chargers and bring back a W back to Carolina. This will be the Panthers, of course, second straight road game, as it will be the Chargers' second straight home game. So hopefully, Panther Nation, we can actually pull up some wins in this and get them. I've got faith in them. I know they can do it. You do as well. So I will try to get this video down and hopefully out. If you like this video, like it, subscribe to my channel, share it, comment on the comments below. If you have any comments, drop them below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And as of course, as always, let's keep pounding, Panther Nation. We've got a young team, and it just takes time. And we can get through it if we just take time. So until next time, with the Panther Prowl here, this is Bill Mack said, keep pounding.